Okay. Based on the first video, let us solve problems on this. Okay. So what is the problem is, the first problem is an amplifier. An amplifier with a forward gain of A0 and two poles at 10 megahertz and 500 megahertz is placed in a unity gain feedback loop. Calculate A0 for a phase margin of 60 degrees. An amplifier with a forward gain of A0 and two poles at 10 megahertz and 500 megahertz in a unity gain feedback loop. Calculate A0 for a phase margin of 60 degree. Okay, so what is the solution of this problem? So it says there are two poles. So I can say omega P1 is equal to 10 megahertz and omega P2 is equal to 500 megahertz. Okay, and phase margin is given as 60 degree. Now I have to calculate what is A0 for a phase margin of 60 degree. Okay, so phase margin is given. Okay, so now what is the actual phase angle? Now actual phase angle is equal to minus 180 degree plus 60 degree is equal to minus 120 degree. Okay, now for two poles I can write it as 1 divided by 1 plus j omega by omega P1 and 1 plus j omega by omega P2. So it can also be written as 1 divided by tan inverse of omega by omega P1 plus tan inverse of omega by omega P2. Okay. So if you see here in this diagram, this is theta, this is 1 and this is omega by omega P. So now I can write it as tan theta is equal to omega by omega P by 1. So it is opposite by adjacent, then we get theta is equal to tan inverse of omega by omega P. Okay, so what we got the actual phase angle now? We got as 120 degree, that is equal to minus of tan inverse of omega by omega P1 minus tan inverse of omega by omega P2. So it is minus 120 degree is equal to minus of tan inverse of A plus tan inverse of B. So it is minus 120 degree is equal to minus tan inverse of A plus B divided by 1 minus AB. I can write in that way. Okay. So now omega, because omega into 1 over 10 divided by 1 over 500, right? Because 10 megahertz and 500 megahertz, so root 3 into 1 minus of omega square divided by 10 into 500. Okay, so I can write it as 500 plus 10 divided by 5000. If I take an LCM, then minus root 3 into 1 minus omega square divided by 5000. Okay, now multiply both sides by 5000. For simplification purpose, multiply both sides by 5000. Okay, so what we get? We get omega into 510 is equal to minus root 3 into 5000 minus omega square. So I can write it as omega into 510 divided by root 3 is equal to minus 1 into 5000 by omega square. So it is omega into 510 by root 3, that is equal to minus 5000 plus omega square. I'll write it square properly. So it is omega square. So now I can simplify omega square minus omega into 510 by 3 minus 5000 is equal to 0. So now solving the quadratic equation, now a is 1 here and b is equal to minus 510 by root 3 and c is equal to minus 5000. Okay, if you solve the quadratic equation, omega is equal to 310.54, so it is approximately equal to 311 megahertz. It is approximately equal to 311 megahertz we got. Okay, and b, if you solve, it is minus 510 by root 3, you get 294.4. okay, so now I have to calculate the gain, right? That is the question. I have to calculate the gain now. So gain is 20 log, that is gain is equal to 20 log, I have to find out this a naught value, right? A naught value for the phase margin of 60 degree, that is the question. So it is 1 plus j omega 1 by omega p1, okay, into 1 plus j omega 1 by omega p2, okay, that is equal to 0. Okay, so now I can write it as 20 log a by bc is equal to 0. Okay, so it is 20 log a minus 20 log bc is equal to 0. So I can write it as 20 log a minus 20 log b minus 20 log c is equal to 0. So I can simplify this still further. 20 log a naught minus 20 log magnitude of 1 plus j omega 1 by omega p1, okay, minus 20 log magnitude of 1 plus j omega by omega p2, that is equal to 0. So if I take this 20 log to that side, then it becomes a positive. So it is 20 log of what we got, the value of that omega 1, it is j 311 divided by omega P1, we know it is 10 megahertz plus 20 log, it is 1 plus, again omega 1 we got as 311 megahertz, so 311 divided by omega P2, it is given in the problem as 500 megahertz. So if I calculate this, 20 log into 31.1 plus 20 log into 1.177, so it is 20 log, not log, I have taken log now, it is 20 into 1.49 plus 20 into 0.070, you get 29.85 plus 1.41, so you get 31.26 dB. So A naught in dB is nothing but 20 log A naught. Okay, so this is what the answer, it is A naught value will be 31.26 dB. Okay, so still you can calculate this log 31.1, that is 1.492 into 20, if you do it you get 29.85. you can calculate. So A naught in dB is equal to 20 log A naught. Okay, now let us solve the second problem. Okay, an amplifier with a forward gain of A naught has 2 coincident poles, at omega P. Okay, then calculate the maximum value of A naught for a 60 degree phase margin with a closed loop gain of, in that sub question they have asked, first case we have to solve for unity and second case we have to solve for 4. An amplifier with a forward gain of A naught has 2 coincident poles at omega P. Calculate the maximum value of A naught for a 60 degree phase margin with a closed loop gain of, first case it is unity, second case it is 4. Okay, let us do the solution for this. See, pole coincide means it is a double pole. Okay, one pole it is going to contribute as minus 20 dB per decade and zeros it is going to contribute as plus 20 dB per decade. So, two coincident pole means it is a double pole. So, it is a fall will be minus 40 dB per decade. Okay. So, now I will write it as A naught is nothing but 1 plus J omega by omega P. Okay. Into 1 plus J omega by omega P, that I can write it as A naught divided by, it is 1 plus J omega by omega P whole square, magnitude square. Okay, I can write like this. Okay, so I'll just write the diagram for an understanding. I said no, it the fall will be minus 40 dB per decade. Okay. And this is, I'll just simply writing for a better understanding purpose. So this is my 20. Okay, so this is my 20 log A naught. Okay, so this will be omega P and this will be 10 omega P. And somewhere here, okay, this will be 0.1 omega p. Okay. So there is a 2 coincident pole. Okay. Because this is minus 180 degree. Okay, so this is minus 90 degree. At this particular point, there is minus 90 degree. Okay, understand this. So he has asked the question, calculate the maximum value of A naught for a 60 degree phase margin. So 60 degree. So this will be 60 degree and remaining this may be a 30 degree. Okay, so for 60 degree you may get around 0.67 decade. We will see here. Okay, are you getting it? This is for so I can simply, I can write it as here as 1 plus J1 square. Okay. So what is this fall? This fall is minus 40 dB per decade because two pole is there, two coincide poles. So the fall will be minus 40 dB per decade. Okay. So anyway, this is minus 180 degree. I have written here. Okay, so 45 degree root 2. See, since two poles, how many poles? Since two poles, so it is minus 90 degree per decade, right? Okay, so single pole is going to, single pole, it is going to contribute how much? It is minus 45 degree per decade. Okay, so 90 degree means it is one decade. So 60 means for 90 degree, if it is one decade, for 60 degree, it is how much? So that's what I have written. 60 by 90 if you do, you get 0.67 decade. That is what I have written here. For 60 degree, you are going to get as 0.67 per decade. Okay. Are you getting it? So, here it is. A naught is nothing but A naught divided by 2 at an angle of 90 degree. Okay. Or A naught by 2 at an angle of minus 90 degree. Both are same. Are you getting it? So, so if I move, see, I'll just writing again for your understanding purpose. See, this is 10 omega p. Somewhere around it is 0.67, that is omega 1. This is omega p and this is 90 degree. The same thing I have written. See here, in this diagram, no, this is my omega p, this is my 10 omega p. Between here, if you extend this dotted lines, between here, you are going to get as 0.67 decade. See, if you extend this line, you are going to get here as 0.67 a decade. Okay. So, the same thing I have written here as separately. So, 1 decade is equal to 20 log omega divided by 10 omega p. So, now, if I move 0.67 per decade, then we are getting PM is equal to 60 degree. Okay. So, I can write it as log into 10 omega p by omega p is equal to 1 decade. Right. So, log into 10 omega p by omega 1 is equal to 0.67. So, I can write it as 10 omega p by omega 1 is equal to 10 raised to 0.67. So, I got here as 4.67. Okay. So, omega 1 is equal to, 1 minute. Omega 1 is equal to 10 omega p divided by 4.67. So, omega 1 is equal to 2.14 omega p. So, now we have found out the value of this omega 1. What is that omega 1? That is, this omega 1 we have found out the value now. Okay. So, we have two cases, right? One is for unity, another one is for 4. Okay. So, now I can write it as 20 log gain is equal to 20 log A0 minus 40 dB per decade. Why? Because two coincident pole. So, I can write it as 20 log A0 minus 40 dB per decade is equal to 0. So, it is 20 log A0 is equal to 40 dB per decade. Okay. So, the number of decades corresponding to omega 1 is, that is equal to log of omega 1 by omega p. Now we got the value as what? Log of 2.14 omega p by omega p into 40 dB per decade. This omega p and omega p get cancels, right? So, we get A0 is equal to 13.21 dB. Okay. So, since we know log of 2.14 is equal to 0.33. Okay. So, note for 1 decade is equal to 40 dB, right? Now, 2 decade is 80 dB. Now, we have to calculate, because log 2.14 we got 0.33. So, for 0.33 decade is how much? That is what we have calculated. Okay, so log 2.14 is nothing but 0.33. So, we got A0 is equal to 13.21 dB. Okay. Now, what is the closed loop gain? Our closed loop gain is given by A divided by 1 plus A beta. Okay. When A is large, closed loop gain given by 1 over beta, right? When A is large, okay, so closed loop gain will be 1 over beta. When A is large, let me write full. When A is large, okay, so closed loop gain given by 1 over beta. Okay, so neglect that 1 also. Okay, so now 1 over beta is equal to 4, or beta is equal to 1 over 4. Okay, so for the first case, that is for unity case, we got A naught is equal to 13.21 dB. Now for the second case we are doing it, that is the closed loop gain is given by A divided by 1 plus A beta. Okay, so 1 over beta is equal to 4, so beta is equal to 1 over 4. So now I can write it as overall gain is equal to what? A into beta into 1 plus j omega by omega p. Okay, then again 1 plus j omega by omega p. Okay, so I can write it as, because beta value is 4, a by 4 is 1 plus j omega by omega p into 1 plus j omega by omega p, because two poles are there, right? That's why. Okay, so now 20 log A naught is equal to 13.2 dB for beta is equal to 1. That's what we got now, just now. Okay, so 20 log A by 4 is equal to 13.2 dB. So 20 log A minus 20 log 4 is equal to 13.2. So 20 log A is equal to 13.2 plus 20 log 4. So I can write it as 13.2 plus 12.04. So I get 20 log A is equal to 25.24 dB. Okay, so for beta is equal to 4, if you assume for the case, second case, that is 4, then you get what is the A naught value is 25.24 dB. If you take a unity, that is beta is equal to 1, in that case we got A naught is equal to 13.21 dB. Okay.